Good morning, everybody. Man, has it been one of those mornings. It's like 11 o'clock. I slept until 11 o'clock. Wow. What a way to start the day. Sleep in. Though I did stay up late, so I really didn't oversleep. It's just I stayed up too late. And it's weird when you wake up so late in the morning, people look at you and go, man, how did you sleep into 11? Well, I went to bed at 4 or 5 in the morning watching TV. So I really didn't. I'm not going to explain it. Some of you understand. Some of you were young at one time. Some of you are young now. Though I'm not. I shouldn't be doing that. I should have been staying up all night. It throws the whole body clock off. It does. Bad. Not waking up in the morning, that would just suck. Not waking up at night. Not waking up ever. It's not what I want to do. I'd rather be doing this than never waking up again. No matter how long it takes. Almost done. Welcome to my channel. It's a daily vlog channel. It's my second vlog channel. It's the daily vlog. Sometimes in the morning, do you ever get in those weird moods? Like, I don't know, I'm just in a weird mood. Not happy, not sad. Just kind of weird. A weird mood. It's Sunday. It means tomorrow's a work day. But today's a work day, so I don't have weekends. I work every single day. I never get a day off. Only every couple months I get to take a day off. Checking the inside of my trailer. Just hooking up to this one. It's nice and clean. Clean trailer. Yeah, I don't get days off like most people. It's part of the job. And what a job it is. It's an incredible job. Look at my hair. That's why I have to wear a hat sometimes. Totally unmanageable. I wonder if I should try any other hats. These are fedoras. I used to wear baseball caps. I was always naked in the morning. Before school, before anything when I was younger, had to put my baseball cap on. I could not leave the house without a hat. I don't know if it was self-consciousness because my hair would always be a mess. And in the morning before school, I could just put my hat on, not have to worry about combing my hair or brushing my hair, and just run out the door, catch the bus, never having to worry. Never. I don't know. But I wore a hat for so many years of my life, I felt naked. Felt naked with that one. When I went in the military and they shaved my head bald and gave me those little army hats. That was awesome. I loved it. But after I ETS'd and got out of the military, came back to America, settled down, my hair started to grow back from the baldness that the military gives you. I stopped wearing hats. So I haven't worn a hat. I stopped wearing hats for a good 20 years. Hence my head of hair. No bald spots. A little bit of gray. But no bald spots. And now my son bought me a fedora about 2 Halloween Horror Nights ago. A margarita from Margaritaville. And I started wearing it periodically. Put it in some photo shoots with Google Glass for the websites. And just stuff to post. And I kind of liked it. And then Amy took off and started getting me flea market fedoras. They were fairly inexpensive, and I started wearing them. And now, every day, I'm back to what it was like when I was younger. I cannot leave my house or the cab of the truck when I wake up in the morning without putting a hat on. Though I do brush my hair. I brush my hair. It's still unmanageable. It's at that stage where it's unmanageable, so you just slide it in, and there. See what I mean? I don't know. Let's go pick up our load, shall we? Driving down the road, I finally found out why I feel so blah today. And it's not my fault. It's not my fault I feel blah. It's other people's fault, other companies. I just found out that two of my favorite things, one thing that I loved since the 80s is gone, and something else disappeared today also. One thing at Disney World, MGM Studios, Hollywood Studios, today is the day the ear tower at MGM Studios is gone. They tore it down. Anybody that used to go to Disney, driving on Disney World property, as you exit 192, head onto Disney Park property, on the right-hand side at MGM Studios or Hollywood Studios, I prefer MGM Studios, you would drive past MGM Studios, and on your right-hand side, you would see Twilight Zone Tower of Terror and the big water tower with the Mickey Mouse ears. As of today, it's gone. It's gone. Along with the Streets of America, you know, the street where you walk down and there's a big facade. It looks like you're walking in the city of New York. It's all gone. Everything is gone. Making way for the expansion of Star Wars Land, Toy Story Land, and everything else. Everything else that's changing. The Hollywood Studios, MGM Studios is changing. And it's kind of gone. It was my favorite park forever. It really was. I love Epcot. I really like the Magic Kingdom, but I also love Animal Kingdom. But my favorite park out of all the parks was MGM Studios. You got Rock and Roller Coaster, Twilight Zone, the shows, the attractions. I became a show person, actually. I used to not ride so many rides, especially when I go to the theme parks by myself. You know, standing in those lines, doing every, you know, waiting to get on a ride, standing there all by yourself. It became not me. It wasn't as much fun standing in line by yourself. So I became a show person. Used to go to the Indiana Jones stunt, epic stunt spectacular, and lights, camera, action, or the car show, which I have documented on video. One of the last showings of that. Used to take the Catastrophe Canyon, the Backlot Tour. All that's all gone. Well, not Indiana Jones, but the Backlot Tour's gone. Catastrophe Canyon's gone. Everything's gone. The park is changing, so it's a sad day. Today is the day that the water tower with the mouse ears came down. It's not going to be the same. It's not going to be the same. I've seen other vloggers out there talk about progress. I love the progress. I can't wait for Star Wars Land. I'm really excited about Toy Story Land. But there's just, MGM Studios is losing some of its magic today. Something else that is losing some magic is this. Today is the day, the first, May 1st, Dapper Day. If you're going to Disneyland in California, today is Dapper Day. I should be wearing my tie and nice clothing instead of this shirt I've been wearing for the last 3 days, because I don't know why. I've been in a funk, but today is Dapper Day. There's Mickey right behind me. There's Mickey Mouse. It's Dapper Day at Disneyland. But today is also the day you cannot physically put money on your Google Wallet card anymore. Today this becomes history, a part of Google history. This became a part of Google history a few months back when they stopped supporting this. Well, today they stopped supporting this. It's upside down. No, that was right side up. What am I going to do with this? I'm going to store it for prosperity. I still have money on it. You can still physically use the card if you have money on it. You just can't load money onto this anymore. At the end of the month, it's gone. And I use these all the time. I use this on a daily basis. If I don't use this, I use Tap to Pay. So, but where they don't have Tap to Pay, I use this. So as of today, I'm probably going to have to tie my bank account to my Android Pay, which I was trying to avoid. I'm really going to miss this. definitely need that. Out of bread. Can't make cheese sandwiches without bread. Oh, man. Get back there, bread. Forgot my potato chips. Well, you know what? I can get potato chips anytime. Am I still feeling blah? Yes. Kind of upset a little bit. This coffee is really going to help. I don't know about you guys. It's just, to me, it's a little depressing. Part of my childhood, a part of my youth, a part of my family memories, the family memories that I have, taking my kids when they were younger to Disney, and MGM Studios in particular. Had so much fun at that theme park back in like 2001, 2002, when my kids were still semi-small. I took them to MGM Studios one time, and I pretended we were staying at the hotel. We weren't going to go home. We were going to stay in the hotel. And they thought the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror was our hotel. And I got them into the queue. We went in, got into the elevator, and they thought we were going to the elevator to our room. They didn't know. I totally freaked the kids out. I have so many great memories of MGM Studios, and it's just kind of fading. They're tearing everything up. They're changing. Progress. It's progress. I'm here in Lisle. I don't know if this is Minnesota or Iowa. Lisle. I want to think it's still Minnesota. I don't think I crossed the Iowa border yet. But I am here. Lisle is... Well, there's a water tower. Speaking of water towers, I was just getting over the thought of the tower, the ear tower, at MGM Studios being gone. And there's a water tower just to remind me. Make me sad again. Ah! There's stuff here that kind of can cheer me up a little bit. I've got a new cup of coffee. Curtis has been doing his best barking at me, letting me know, hey, it's not all doom and gloom. There is stuff coming. So, Disney stuff for new generations. You know, life goes on, life goes on. But I am here in Lisle, Minnesota. I believe that the Iowa border's not too far down there, or I am in Iowa. I don't know. I don't know what town this is in. I'm in the middle of farm country. And in the Midwest, in places like Iowa, back in the day, rail. Towns survived because of rail cars. Trains. Trains used to come to every little town. They had train stations, train stops. They would bring grain and stuff from the farmer's fields, which are, I'm sure there's farmer's fields on the other side of this wooded area. They would haul the grain to the cities, the corn, and everything through rail. That's how people here made a living. I'm sure that's still how people today make livings here in towns like this. Though this is a very small town. Trains would travel down these tracks, stop next to mills like that, and they would shoot grain into the train cars, and then the trains would take off and venture forth into the cities, making food for the rest of the country. But this is a pretty amazing little spot. I've often wanted to stop here. Never have stopped here. Just usually pass on by. This is one of those towns you just pass on by. But the reason I wanted to stop here today is to document something long gone, something that you really don't see much of anymore. Now, when I was a kid, I grew up next to some railroad tracks. I live now next to some railroad tracks. But when I grew up in a small town called Rockland, California, just in the foothills, just below the foothills of the Sierra Nevadas, trains would often come over Donner Summit, over the Sierra Nevadas. Look at this, it's a dirt road. This is a road less traveled. That's a road less traveled. Trains would come over the mountains from like Reno or Salt Lake City and stuff, heading to Sacramento. And when I was younger, they built the California Railroad Museum in Old Town Sacramento. you know, and a lot of the trains that ended up in the museum would actually pass by my house. Boy, that wind. My son is getting me a new microphone. It's on its way. So this wind, it's you're not going to have to deal with it much longer. In fact, I'm on my way back to Florida. Hopefully it'll be there by then. But back in the day, at the, you know, they focus mostly, especially at the Railroad Museum, on the engines, on the awesome, awesome engines that traveled across America back in the day. They never focused on the rear of the train, but I always did. I always knew the train was ending, and I could cross the railroad tracks that the train was coming to an end, passing by, when I seen one of these. Da, da, da. A caboose. This is something you never see on trains anymore. Look at that. It's a caboose in a nice little park in a really small town. This little park, what's it called? How's the name here? Get closer here so you can read it. This little park. Welcome to Lyle Memory Gardens. Look at this. I think we can get on there. I think you could actually step on a caboose. Now, I'm getting up there in age. I don't think I've ever stood on a caboose. Now, on a facade of a caboose at Disneyland when I was younger, one of my friends, my grandmother, and myself actually took a picture. I'm going to try and recreate that. I'm going to recreate that picture. My grandma's passed away. I don't know where my friend is. It was one of the grade school friends. But at Disneyland, and I believe at Disney World, there's a caboose like this. You know, and people used to wave. In the old days, they used to stand on the back here as the train travels down the track. Politicians, movie stars, whatever. And they'd wave to the crowds from the back of a caboose. And, they do the same thing at Disneyland, but it's a facade. It's just a photo. It's a picture spot. You stand there, and they charge $20, and you get your picture taken on the back of a caboose. And I still have that image from years and years ago, Disney's Days Gone By, of my grandmother, my friend, and me standing right here. I also have a picture of my sister. There's one of my grandmother, my sister, and me on the back of a caboose, just like this. That's the one I have. I actually have that one. That's saved in my Google Drive. Let's try and recreate this. Let's set up this little tripod here. Let's sit right here. Okay, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go up there and recreate this. Hold on a second. I believe in the photograph, my grandmother is right here in the middle. I'm over here, and my sister would be over here. So just pretend there's two other people here with me. And we're waving. Pretty awesome. Let's take you guys up on there. Let's show you what it's like to stand on a caboose. On a caboose, look at this. This brake handle. I got the braking system right here so you can stop and turn and stop. Full release, non-spin. Don't know what all this does. If anybody knows, let me know. What is this, a brake? Is this a brake? And what does this do? That locks the wheel? Or is this a release? Is this a release for that? I don't know if that's a release for that or not. Door's all locked up. Can't really get in. I would love to go inside and see what it's like in there. There's a lot of little Midwestern towns that have similar things. They either have engines, locomotives, or they have stuff like this. It's a nice little town park. benches to sit. Little trails, there's little trails, little garden trails you can walk around. This is what makes it nice. You could look at this. Wow. Definitely would not want to sit there. No, don't want to sit there. But driving through towns like this, seeing stuff like this, Americana. It's a roadside attraction. If you want to make it one, you can stop by. Check all this out. I'm going to hold the camera up. There's a window up here. It's way too tall for me, but maybe you guys could take a peek inside. Don't know what it looks like in there. I got to review the video. I can't see in there. I don't know if you guys could see in there. A caboose. A caboose. I'm not talking about your rump. I'm talking about part of a train. A caboose. Look at this place. It's awesome. It is water faucet. I wonder if you can turn it on. I wonder if water comes out of it. Let's see if I open this up, if water comes out. Oh, yep. Yep. Water came out. It's active. Water does work. We have water. Look at these. Tulips. I think that's what they are. Not sure. They're not petunias. But anybody traveling down this road, I don't even know what road I'm on. 287, I believe. And Lyle, this has to be, I believe this is Minnesota still. It's right on the border. It's right on the border of Iowa and Minnesota. So I'm not exactly sure. You guys have to Google it. Yes, I travel through here all the time, and I don't even know. I never pay attention. Just know it's Lyle. Little park over there for the children to play, playgrounds, tennis courts. That must be a school because it says athletics on it. Must be a high school of some kind. The Lyle High School. It just blows me away. Streets of dirt. Highway 218. That's what I'm on. Highway 218. Just outside of Austin, Minnesota. This is a quaint little town. Quaint. Quiet. Not too many people here. I don't know what the population is. But I'm going to go get back in the truck and continue on down the road. Try and find some other stuff to add to this. To add to this daily vlog. Just checking this out. Old building. I was able to find this parking lot to park in. Let's head back. Let's get back in the truck. Back in the truck, getting ready to pull out of this parking lot. I'll go ahead and show you guys this quaint little town. It's very, very small. Very small. I believe this is Main Street. That's the town. That's all there is here. Let's go see if we can find something else. Should be able to find something. If I'm I'm going to go anywhere else, I definitely need to get some fuel. It's time. Real fast, sitting on the fuel island, just pump fuel, ran inside, got my chips before anybody else is done fueling and needs to pull up. I'm gonna try and knock out some quick cheese sandwiches. Quick, let's do this fast. Fast. Ooh. Really don't want fast food. There's a McDonald's and an Arby's down the street. Not my choice to eat and drive that kind of food. I'm trying to make myself feel better. Eating fast food, usually an hour later, I don't feel all that good about myself. Making something in the truck, definitely feel good, especially after some good thick cheddar cheese slices, deli cut, thick, good. All I need is bacon. Add a little bacon to this, it would be perfect. But it's not perfect, but it's close to perfect.
Time to eat dinner. Where am I going to eat? Right here, the world's largest truck stop in Walcock, Iowa. I've been trying to vlog this for quite a while, but they always play background music in here from the radio, and usually YouTube cuts it. So I'm going to try and silence it. And just maybe if there's music, maybe talk over it, maybe that'll work. I don't know. But let's go take a look inside the truck stop before I hit the restaurant. Where we get all our accessories. All of them. Most of them. Look at the mural. The mural on the side of this trailer. Pretty cool. Pretty nice. It's actually not paint, it's a sticker. I always thought it was painted on. Look right here, it's a sticker though. When I get my motorcycle, I'm thinking about doing the same thing. It's like a funhouse mirror. Thinking about doing the same thing. Thinking about maybe turning my bike when I get it into a TARDIS, or maybe do the whole paint scheme, because it's a Yamaha, so it's blue and white, so the blue part should be easy to cover up. But I'm thinking maybe a weeping angel. Turn my bike into a weeping angel. Yeah, why not? Why can't I do that?
Right here. I don't know if it's showing up. That's my favorite color, blue. The wall of lights. That's a wall of lights.
You know, if I keep eating too much fast food, I'm gonna have to change my name.
True. Pretty awesome. I'm gonna go grab something to eat.
But on the way to the restaurant, there's more. That wasn't it. That's just part of it. It's also
your knife. You can get knives, rings, clothing. They even have a food court. Sturgis. Candles, smell good stuff. So much fun stuff here. But check this out. Yeah, that's kind of cool. 3D, super 3D dartboard. Pretty awesome. Let's go grab something to eat. Never get enough coffee. Omelet. Perfect dinner. Tummy's full. Yes. Kind of generic, though I'm used to the Disney ones. What is this? Magic Mike. Not the movie. I don't think that's how you spell it. No really nice clothing. Nothing that I should see. What am I getting one of these? Mounts right here? What am I getting? Maybe something about that size. Not for the price though. You can get it cheaper at Best Buy. Head on out the doors, back to the truck. End this daily vlog. Maybe spending the night here. I'm having a small issue with my Nexus 6. I don't know if it's because of Android N, or I don't know if it's because I went in my Google Voice and changed my account a little bit. The phone number from my Google Voice, I changed from my number from Sprint, because I was gonna put my Nexus 6 on Project Fi. And I guess you're supposed to cancel. Let me get past this truck. I guess you're supposed to cancel Google Voice, because they keep trying to send me a phone, keep saying, you know, in my area, Project Fi works great. You know, so I was gonna take my Nexus 6 off of Sprint and put it on Project Fi. But to do that, I was supposed to cancel Google Voice. Now I did that, but now my phone doesn't, all it does now is do data. I can't send or receive phone calls, don't know what's up with it. So I'm gonna go back to the truck I'm gonna decide whether to spend the night here or head further down the road about 2 more hours. But before I do, I wanna log into my Chromebook, go to googlevoice.com or whatever it is, and reactivate that phone number to Google Voice to see if that actually works and reactivates my phone to where I could make calls or receive calls, because right now it's not working. And that's my primary phone number. Out of all the phones I have, that's my primary. So let's go. I'm going to go back to the truck here and give it a shot. It did not work. I've been sitting here for an hour trying to fix my Google Voice to my normal phone account. It didn't work. Everything started going good. This morning was kind of messed up with the notification that the water tower came down at Disney. A Google Wallet, I'm not allowed to put money on that no more. And then all of a sudden I get to see a really cool caboose of a choo-choo train. Then I get to come here to the world's largest truck stop and eat. And then I figured, okay, I'm on an upswing. Still, this damn device, something happened about a month ago during the last update to Android N where I cannot make and receive calls. Don't know what it is. I thought I was on an upswing. I went up, leveled off a little bit for dinner. Now right back down. Now I'm looking at my hair. Where's my hat? See what I mean about hair and hats? All right, guys, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching today's daily vlog. Check out my other channel, the Almost Daily Vlog channel, as you can hear my reefer going in the background. So much noise. Just a miserable day. Miserable. It's been rainy, gloomy. Who am I kidding? I'm happy to be alive. But once again, thank my Patreon supporters, Chris Kitchen, India Maiden, and Jolene Bowler. You guys rock. Until tomorrow on the Daily Vlog. Peace.